Over the course of the last months, Breath of the Wild speedrunning has turned from this into this. This is the start of a series that will teach you the new speedrun strategies and routing for the Any% category, where you beat the game as fast as possible, essentially defeating Ganon in your underwear. Starting by exploring the Any% route through the Great Plateau, which makes an appearance in all speedrun categories in some form, as it cannot be skipped. Now, a fair warning, these strategies are hard and will need some serious dedication and willingness to spend time learning them. But if you do that practice, you will have a blast running this game. I mean, come on, you will literally be flying to save the princess. In this first video, I will go over all of the basic strats that you will need to speedrun Breath of the Wild. So this will be a pretty long one. Bust out the notebook, here we go. As of April 25th, the 1.6 software update for the digital version of the game on Nintendo Switch is the fastest version to speedrun Breath of the Wild. I personally run with a Nintendo Switch Pro controller, but many other runners prefer Joy-Cons to deal with whistle sprinting, which we will get into soon. You want to play on French text and French voice acting, as this is the fastest language to run the game in. To switch to that, change your console's system language. I play with gyro aiming enabled, which is both useful and problematic in certain spots. I will get into these later. And lastly, camera speed should be on very fast, which will help you to speed up various setups throughout the speedrun. Now, whistle sprinting is a way of not only infinite sprinting, but also refilling your stamina while you do it. It is performed by holding down the whistle button and then constantly mash the sprint button while doing that. Whistle sprinting is slightly slower than normal sprinting, so optimally you want to constantly switch between sprinting and then whistle sprinting and so forth to refill your stamina when you need it. Now, keep in mind that for some other actions like climbing, you must have stamina available, so you need to manage accordingly. You can whistle sprint up less steep slopes though. I highly recommend to learn the claw grip for your controller to seamlessly do this. Make sure to hold your Pro controller just like this. This might be easier with Joy-Cons for you, but claw gripping is essential to master the movement in this game. I know, it's annoying and it's uncomfortable, but getting used to it will make you a better speedrunner of this game. Throw sprinting is a less consistent way of infinite sprinting than whistle sprinting, with the huge difference that it is a lot quieter. While you whistle sprint, you will alarm enemies and scare the wildlife, both being things we want to avoid during certain sections of our speedrun. To keep moving quick in these sections, we use throw sprinting. Throw sprinting is performed by mashing both the sprint and the throw button on your controller at the same time. If Link fully goes into the throw animation, make sure to cancel it with B and then proceed mashing. Once again, this is way less consistent than whistle sprinting, so you only want to perform this when you need to be quiet. Shield movement is very crucial for speedrunning this game, to say the least. Make sure to mess around with it on a file before implementing it in runs. To start a shield surf, you want to jump and then press the target button and A mid-air. Now, I personally start holding the target button just before I jump and then roll my thumb from X to A. Shield surfing is used in various locations throughout the run to gain extra speed, but the initial shield jump before you go into the shield surf state can be used as some sort of double jump. During the speedrun, we want to preserve our shield durability. To be able to do that mid-shield jump, you want to unequip the shield mid-air just before you land. Fall damage cancelling, as the name suggests, allows you to avoid taking fall damage. To do this, you need to start throwing your weapon mid-air, but unequip an item just before Link lets go of the weapon. So let's break this down. First, you want to hold the throw button until you're at a low enough spot, as these inputs will reset the position the game thinks Link started falling from. Now at that spot, you want to let go of the throw button. And just as Link starts to throw his weapon, press the D-pad quick menu button to equip or unequip any item. Now, I would recommend to you right now to get used to doing this with your shield as the item you'll un- and re-equip. In actual runs, you will be unequipping your shield to start falling down and then re-equipping your shield to actually make the fall damage cancel happen. You can, and you should, practice this in casual fights or anywhere really. I highly recommend getting these inputs into your muscle memory. Cancelling Link's two-handed weapon spin animation can be crucial for setting up stasis launches, which we will get into in many sections of the actual speedrun route later on. Now, doing this is way easier than you might think. All you need to do is press B while Link is spinning. Link will now stop spinning without performing his slam attack. Now, on that topic, when spin attacking, sometimes you want to be facing your back to the target you're hitting. Regardless of stasis object or enemy, this will cause you to get what we call double hits, which is often required to kill something faster or even charge an object that is stasis faster. Just make sure to get a feeling for getting double hits consistently whenever you need them. Wow, now this actually turned out a little bit shorter than I thought it would, but in the next video I will talk about the two newest and most crucial tricks for the most up-to-date speedrun route. Those are the most advanced tricks and they will need their own video. First one being the shield clip, and second one being the very impressive looking bullet time bounce. So stay tuned and make sure to subscribe. I also speedrun the game almost daily on my Twitch channel, which is linked in the description. You're always welcome if you have any questions. But now, good luck with the practice and see you in the next one.